I want it to be a surprise since you haven't seen the new house yet.
Cute.
Go look at the kitchen.
Oh, okay, yeah. I like this.
I'm really excited for you to see your new bedroom.
I like this table.
You do?
Yes.
Okay. Well, come here. Hold on.
Okay.
Hold your horses.
Cute. I like it. It looks good.
Yeah, we gotta put that TV up.
Hey, can we switch those back again?
What? The Twilight dolls? You want them different?
Yeah, I want that one.
Hold on, I gotta run get something ready. I want to show you the office area down here, how we got the computer set up.
Hey.
Where's he at?
Yeah.
Yeah. I want you to check out this awesome computer desk, Kenzie.
Yeah, it only took me 5.5 days to put it together.
Hey, I got
2 minutes. Hey there, girl.
Gunner, Gunner, be quiet. You thought you had 5 days. Is that a good surprise?
Oh.
She's like, I've only got 5 days till I see Daddy. Did you see how shocked she was? Why don't you jump down and show Daddy how tall you are? She says she's getting too tall and her feet are getting too big like yours. Hush, Gunner. See, I was excited to see Daddy too. A little too excited.
That's so cool, dude.
So how happy are you?
A lot.
She stood there for a few minutes before she got through her hand.
So sweet. We tried it. We were going to try to surprise you at school, but Daddy's flight was late. So we thought we'd surprise you here. Were you shocked?
What?
Hi, Callie. Look who's here.
Oh, Callie Bear.
Oh, who is it?
Callie
B. Who is it? Oh, yeah. Come here.
I love you, Kelly Bear. Kelly B.
Who's here? Who's here, Callie?
I love you, Callie. Come here.
Come here, Callie. Callie, come here. Where's Callie? Where's Bo? Where's Bo? There's Nana. Get Bo. Yeah. Yeah.
Shut up!
Christ.
Oh my God. How long are you back for?
I'll be back for 18 minutes. Man, are you serious?
Well, thanks for serving.
Thank you.
He just got back from Afghanistan.
Oh, Lord. I don't even want to work anymore.
Huh?
I don't want to work.
I'm leftover spaghetti. Uh-huh. Oh, leftover corn on the cob.
That was good corn.
I haven't seen anything cooking right now.
Ah! Oh!
I was out there.
Oh, oh my gosh! Oh, Paul, oh. What are you home for?
I'm here till May 5th.
Till May 5th?
Yep.
Oh, home for your birthday, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh. If you were here.
Yeah, I was for a minute there, Mom. I was like, oh, no, she knows.
No, I didn't know. That's why Dad wanted the camera, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, anybody else know?
Yes.
Oh, that's why you were getting the room done right then, huh? Oh.
Oh, you guys.
They're tears of happiness. Good to see you guys.
He's done.
I'm done. It's over.
The whole thing is over,
right?
I see why Mom asked me to him, man.
Yeah. Figured it out now?
Yeah. I really figured it. Daddy!
Hello. He got to meet him first.
Tomorrow I have to wear pink. See? Yeah, I'm a baby girl with pink.
Are you very surprised?
Yeah.
Tell you about a tearful reunion that has been months in the making.
A local military dad travels halfway around the world to surprise his teenage daughter. Fox 5's Caitlin Pratt has the story.
Shelby Usery had her gloves, her shin pads, and as captain of the Thunder Soccer Club, her team spirit, all ready to go for the first game in Saturday's tournament. What the 11-year-old didn't have is any idea. Her one holiday wish was about to come true. Shelby is a goalie. The net inside these posts is special to her. So it was fitting that one of the most special people in her life, her father, would be standing there. Army National Guard Sergeant Richard Usery has been in Iraq for a year.
Okay. Love you.
I do.
A recent ankle injury made a Christmas visit home a possibility, but
You gotta let go.
Shelby's mother, her soccer coaches were all in on the surprise. A surprise hard to hide the last few days that had to be put in place.
Very careful and a lot of sneaking around where she wouldn't know what was going on.
I thought she turned around once, but the coach kind of got her attention back a couple of times.
Engineered so that this father could see his daughter doing what she loves, what he's missed all season long.
See you play.
It's an unexpected gift.
Well, I still have tears in my eyes, so I know it's the best for me. I don't know about her, but I can tell you it's the best for me.
In Athens, Caitlin Pratt, Fox 5 News.
Precious moment. Sergeant Ussery will be home for 3 days before he returns to Fort Hood, Texas. Now, it's unclear right now when he'll be home for good. Those plans depend on whether the sergeant has to go any surgery for his ankle.
The Lawler family loves attending sporting events, but this time it's bittersweet because the family's biggest fan, Dad, isn't there.
He's serving our country in Kosovo right now.
And what's been the hardest part to not have him around the last few months?
Well, I'm just getting used to not being able to give him a hug.
This is the first Christmas the Lawler girls will spend without their dad.
I really don't like it, and I wish he could just come home for the holidays.
All I want for Christmas is to have him come back.
What the girls don't know is that they're getting a gift early, but it won't fit underneath the tree. Dad, Sergeant Thomas Lawler, is home on leave.
We're trying to make it pretty memorable for the kids. This is the first time I've been deployed overseas.
He hasn't seen his family in more than 3 months.
I'm ecstatic to be here right now.
But upon his arrival at tonight's big Bobcat game, his kids have no idea he's only feet away.
Are you nervous?
Very nervous.
He spends the first period of the game incognito, getting ready for the big reveal. Okay.
Is that too tight?
Nope.
Now it's showtime.
If you had a chance to make one Christmas wish come true, what would it be?
For my dad to come home.
You would like for your dad to come home for Christmas? And did you wish really hard? You think we could maybe make that happen? What do you think? Goalie, can you help us?
Love you guys.
A wish come true for one family, reminding all of us the true meaning of Christmas.
So shocked, but it's the best Christmas ever now. It's the best Christmas present I've ever had.
With KX News, I'm Megan Lowry.
I don't even understand her, man.